Good afternoon, my brothers and sisters, and welcome to our Eucharistic celebration this afternoon. We are in the 12th Sunday of Ordinary Time, and we offer our Mass today for the eternal repose of the soul of Mary Sembler. And also we remember all our fathers, as we are celebrating Father's Day today, and those fathers who have passed away. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us now prepare ourselves to celebrate this Mass by first acknowledging our sins and be sorry for them. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within the doors the sea, when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment, and thick darkness its swaddling bands, when I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door, and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no farther, and here shall your proud waves be stilled.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat, just as he was. And other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat, so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep in a cushion. They walked him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He walked up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith? They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even wind and sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our readings for today, especially the first reading and the Gospel, are tied up by that scene of the storm, of violence, of just being in danger and risking one's life. We encounter a lot of storms in our own lives, difficulties, challenges that can be equated to a storm, that we worry. There's the storm of illness, storm of death in the family. separations of different families, divorce, death of a child, there's this deep sense of anxiety in us because of our financial status. Maybe we cannot even pay the bills. Or maybe we're looking for a new place to stay because our rent is up. Maybe somebody in our family have ventured out of faith. They're not practicing anymore. And we fear. And we're fearful of them. Some of them have finished college, probably graduated, and don't know where to go. Some have fallen into addictions of various forms of alcohol, of drugs. Some have indulged in promiscuous lifestyle, temptations of the flesh. We so would gladly face and overcome, but it seems to be an uphill battle. There's the disagreements that you have within family members, quarrels that have been with us for many years. These are different storms, and none of us are ever immune or exempted from it. We face these difficulties every day. There will be times in our lives when, out of desperation, looking for answers, we look up to heaven and ask God, why? Why is this happening to me? Can you give me an explanation? I've been good to you. It seems to be that God is not hearing our prayers. The first reading of today gives us that glimpse in the story of Job. Job is a good man. He's a righteous man. But he's also a rich man. He has a lot of property. His wealth is just boundless. He has a lovely family with good children. But then one day, he lost all of this. He lost all his properties by fire. And some people took it away from him. And then a tragic thing happened. His children died too. So he was left by himself. But then he got this terrible illness. He developed some boils all over his body, so painful that he would get a glass to rub off his skin to have some comfort because of the pain that's all over his body. Well, not to add comfort to it, his wife kept nagging him. He said, too much of your righteousness. Go and swear to God and curse him. Stop that righteousness of yours. Curse God. Because if he loves you, this would not have happened to you. His friends were not of help anyway. They come to visit him and try to debate him and tell him, you know, abandon God now. But he kept on responding to them in a positive way. But then when all of his friends all the arguments have died down, he was all by himself now. And looking at his condition, and he looked up to God, Lord, why? And then in the book of Job, chapter 38, which is our first reading of today, when God responded, when everybody was talking, God listened, now it was God's turn. He responded. He responded with a question. And he says, then the Lord answered Job out of the storm and said, who is this who darkens counsel with words of ignorance? Gird up your loins now like a man. I will question you and you tell me the answers. Where were you when I founded the earth? Tell me if you have understanding. Who determined its size? Surely you know. Who stretched out the measuring line for it? Into what were its pedestals sunk? And who laid its cornerstone? While the morning stars sang together and all the sons of God shouted for joy? Who shut within the doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garments and thick darkness its swaddling bands. When I set limits for it and fastened the bars of its doors and said, thus far shall you come, but no further, and here shall your proud waves stop. Have you ever in your lifetime commanded the morning and shown the dawn its place? For taking hold of the ends of the earth till the wicked are shaken from it. The earth is changed as clay by the seal and dyed like a garment. But from the wicked their light is withheld, and the arm of the pride, and the arm of pride is shattered. Have you entered the sources of the sea, or walk about on the bottom of the deep? Have the gates of death been shown to you, or have you seen the gates of darkness? Have you comprehended the breadth of the earth? Tell me, if you know it all. What is the way to the dwelling of light and darkness? Where is its place? That you may take it to its territory and know the path to its home? You know because you were born there, and the number of your days is great. Have you entered the storehouses of the snow and seen the storehouses of the hail, which I have reserved for times of distress, for a day of war and battle? What is the way to the parting of the winds? When the east wind spreads over the earth, who has laid out a channel for the downpour and a path for the thunderstorm to bring rain to uninhabited land, the unpeopled wilderness, to drench the desolate wasteland till the desert blooms with venture? Has the rain a father? Who has begotten the drops of dew? Out of those womb comes the ice, and who gives the hoarfrost its birth in the skies? When the waters lie covered as though with stone that holds captive the surface of the deep, have you tied cords to the Pleiades or loosened the bonds of Orion? Do you know the ordinances of the heavens? Can you put into effect their plan on the earth? Can you raise your voice to the clouds for them to cover you with a deluge of waters? Can you send forth the lightnings on their way so that they will say to you, here we are? Who gives wisdom to the ibis and gives the rooster understanding? Who counts the clouds with wisdom? Who tilts the water jars of heaven so that the dust of earth is fused into a mass and its clods sticks together? Do you hunt the prey for the lion, or appease the hunger of young lions while they crouch in their dens or lie in ambush in the thicket? Who provides nourishment for the raven when its young cry out to God, wandering about without food? Do you know the mountain when mountain goats are born and watch for the birth pangs of deer? Number the months that they must fulfill and know when they give birth. The wings of the ostrich flap away. Her plumage is lacking in feathers. When she abandons her egg on the ground and lets them warm in the sand, she forgets that a foot may crush them or the wild beast may trample them. She cruelly disowns her young, and her labors is useless. She has no fear, for God has withheld wisdom from her and given her no share in understanding. Yet, when she spreads her wings high, she laughs at the horse and rider. Do you give the horse his strength, the cloth his neck with a mane? Do you give him quiver like a locust, while his thunder's snorting spreads terror? He plows the valley, he rejoices in his strength, and charges into battle. He laughs at fear and cannot be terrified. He does not retreat from the sword, Around him rattles his quiver, flashes the spear and the javelin. Frenzied and trembling, he devours the ground. He does not hold back at the sound of the trumpet. And the trumpet's call, he cries, "Aha!" Even from afar, he scents the battle. He roars the roar of the officers and the shouting. Does the eagle fly up at your command to build his nest up high? On a cliff he dwells and spends the night. On the spur of cliff or fortress, from there he watches for his food, his eyes behold it afar. His shun once greedily drink blood, where the slain are, there is he. The Lord then answered Job and said, "Will one who argues with the Almighty be corrected? Let him who instruct God give answer." Then Job answered the Lord and said, "Look, I am of little account. What can I answer you? I put my hand over my mouth. I have spoken once, I will not reply. Twice, but I will do so no more." What a beautiful response, a conversation. When things are just so hard for us, when things are not working our way, it's so easy to talk to God and blame him for everything, as if he has nothing to do with everything that's going on, that he has no plans for you and me. But he has. He may be sleeping at the stern of the boat, but it doesn't mean that he doesn't care. It doesn't mean that he doesn't know. It doesn't mean that he doesn't have any concern for our own mundane concerns and wants and desires and challenges. He does. He does. If he can create this beautiful, magnificent world that we have and hold it in existence by his hands and by his power, how much more he can take care of your own needs. Trust. Trust in God. Trust that you are loved by God, that you are the apple of his eye. And knowing that you are loved by God, and knowing in your heart that someone far, far greater than you loves you and cares for you, should satisfy your heart that there's no challenges and storms in life that will ever break your spirit, because you believe that someone loves you, and that's your God. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
With our faith nourished by the words of Scripture, let us voice our needs in prayer to the Lord our God.
That the church throughout the world may be united in prayer for the ongoing conversion of those who still do not know Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who preach and teach the word of God in our world may boldly proclaim the promise of salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That lawmakers may work to reflect care and compassion for the poor and vulnerable in our society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
In thanksgiving for all creation and for all life, which comes from the Lord of the earth, the sky, and the sea, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all fathers on this Father's Day, may we encourage and strengthen them to be faithful in their calling and to give themselves in love to their family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those serving in the military, may they be protected from harm and return home safely. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our nation may heed the gospel call to reform our lives by ending the practice of abortion, euthanasia, and capital punishment. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the souls of the departed, let they be remembered in this Mass, especially Tom Martin and Henry Quinn. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for Mary Semler, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father, you give us all we need. As you answer these prayers, increase our gratitude and our faith. We pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Our gift bearers today are Tony and Vivian McNichol, who are celebrating their 57th wedding anniversary. Our second collection is for Music Ministry and Father's Day.
Please join now in singing number 637, Be Not Afraid, number 637.
You shall cross.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all the Church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. The bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Mary Sembler, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. In our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
please join with me in singing Taste and See.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished with the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask for your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Can we open the inset back cover with music here now? And together we pray,
Lord Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O Lord Jesus, hear me. Within your wounds, conceal me. Do not permit me to be parted from you. From the evil foe, protect me. At the hour of my death, call me, and bid me come to you, to praise you of all your saints, forever and ever. Amen.
Can I get the seat? We would like to welcome Father Frank. Please pray that his transition period to our time is experiencing it now. And also, we have a wonderful project coming up. Our youth would be going to an annual retreat. It's a Steubenville retreat, and it's going to be in Orlando. It will be from all over the U.S. We'll be going there, and we have participants coming from our delegates coming from our area. I would like to ask Savannah to explain more about it and ask for your support and prayers.
Hello, I am Savannah Bendick, as Father Kenny said, and I'm part of the youth group. I'm also an altar server and a reader, as you all can kind of tell, and you've probably seen me around. And before I start, can I have all those that are attending Steubenville just come up to the front? I know we have a few.
All right, Jeremy is one of those, and Dominic and Natasha.
And there are 19 youth and 6 chaperones that are attending this retreat. And I'm going as well, obviously. And I went last year, as well as some other people that are not here today, and this retreat is amazing. It really, you know, gets you closer to your faith and to God, and it was just an amazing 3-day experience. And for these two, and I think Dom is going as well as a chaperone, if I'm correct, I mean, they're gonna be just blown away by the experience, as I was when I went. And for this retreat, because it is a little costly, we are doing some fundraisers as a youth, and we wish that you would help us. We have a raffle, which is when we raffle off a mug and a poster of a certain saint. We have a car wash on June 27th, and we also have a spaghetti dinner on July 11th, and the tickets are $7. So if you could please help us as we go to this retreat and support us by coming to one of these events or just even giving donations, we'd really appreciate that. And as well as the retreat, I am going to lead, which is 5 days prior to the retreat, and that's an extra amount of money. So we would really appreciate if, you know, people in the parish would really help us as we're going to grow closer to our faith and to God. Thank you.
And don't forget, across the church at the Knights Hall, they're having a family event day. So for those of you, I think it's not raining, so there's no sun. It's going to be good. I mean, there's a lot of bouncing, you know, house bounce. House bounce, hot dogs, burgers, all the good stuff. All the good stuff will be there. So bring your family with you. Check them out after Mass today. They're over there on the other side. Don't forget also, next week is our monthly chicken wings and fish fry, which I will be cooking at the social hall. That will be right after the 4 o'clock p.m. Mass and up to about 9 o'clock in the evening. So, 8 o'clock something. So please come and join us there too. Next week we have an open mic for those who wish to show their talents in singing. We have an open mic there too. Our religious education registration is now available. That will be for this upcoming school year. And you can register in the church office or online on our church website. For more information, can you contact Miss Kathy Johnson? Today is Father's Day, and this is a special day that we give thanks to our fathers who have been for us models and pillars of our families, providers. And we ask our fathers to please stand and let us extend our hand over all the fathers and pray for them, okay? God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the examples of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's give our Father a big
hand.
We were kind of thinking, what, you know, some of you might be thinking, what can we give our fathers? What would be the best thing to give our fathers? Well, give them the remote. Okay? And don't bother them the whole day tomorrow. Give them the remote. Don't give them any to-do list. Just leave them alone. Let them do their stuff. That would be the best Father's Day that you can give probably to them. Or maybe cook them a steak and give them a beer. You can add that to that. And today is a special day for Tony and Vivian. They're celebrating their 57th year. Tony and Vivian, kindly stand. And I know you're sitting down there. You can just look at the back and extend your hand. Father Frank, you can join me. Let's pray over Tony and Vivian. Lord our God, bless this couple, Tony and Vivian, as they celebrate their 57th wedding anniversary. Continue to bless them with good health, happiness, and peace in their hearts. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May I request our communion minister to the sick to come forward. Tony and Cecilia, as you receive the body of Christ and give them to the sick, assure them the prayers and support of this community and the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you. Then we have Diane Foot to receive the vocations crucifix. Diane will be praying for vocations to the priesthood, permanent diaconate, for seminaries, and for those who are married. Thank you, Diane. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
And now let us sing number 612, Faith of Our Fathers. Number 612.